I have no idea why Disney did not release screeners in advance for Black is King so that we could all tell you to watch it in advance. Although Beyonce doesn't need that much help. The Beehive was very active and buzzing this morning, you'll see that Black is King is trending on Twitter at the very, very top. Blew Umbrella Academy out of the water, social media-wise. You know, you would think, oh, does Black is King want to debut on the same day as the Umbrella Academy? It does! Because apparently there's no competing with it. At least, again, on social media. I'm surprised at how much I enjoyed it. I sat down to watch it in my living room this morning, and I was transported not just to Africa, but also I felt to a museum. I felt very much like I was watching a piece of art. So it's not perfect, and we'll discuss that, but I think it's, again, like Hamilton, something everyone should see. All right, so when I was little, my parents bought a compilation of Michael Jackson music videos. I loved that, and we would watch it all the time. I also really enjoyed growing up watching Fantasia. You know, some people might be like, should Black is King be on Disney Plus? I think children in particular would really enjoy this. And I think in some ways it is meant for children because of the themes in it. And I think that's very admirable. And I would say that Black is King is in the same vein as those ambitious projects, Michael Jackson's music video works and also Disney's Fantasia, in its efforts to draw attention to music as art. And it's very inspiring to see mainstream artists using their platforms to expose their audiences to not just art, but high art. The Disney connection, besides this being, I think, somewhat targeted at younger audiences, I think it's very fitting because of Fantasia that Disney Plus is where Black is King would debut. And there are also striking similarities to Hamilton, which just also recently debuted on Disney Plus. I mean, while Hamilton is nowhere near as striking visually, it can be, I think, also put into this same category as it uses mainstream music and culture to bring attention to American history. So what is Beyonce highlighting here? I would say, like Black Panther, also from Disney, Black is King is part of the current movement from the Black community to not only define themselves, but to present themselves not as victims, but as beautiful and powerful. As I talked, you know, I talked about the importance of Black Panther. You know, Roots was so iconic for depicting the Black experience and calling attention to it in entertainment. And that was really acknowledging what happened in the past. And I felt that Black Panther was now turning the attention to the future, you know, literally creating a city on a hill, even if it's fictional, and that being Wakanda. And I think that Beyonce is tying into that, you know, pushing the viewpoint forward. Let's see what we're going to accomplish. And, you know, let's put that chapter behind us and no longer have it weigh us down. By no means, of course, it should ever be forgotten, but I think this is a movement to say that shouldn't define us. And I think I'm really in favor of that. I think it's a great thing. Now, some might wrongly interpret Black is King to mean Black is the king. But I think that's not correct. I believe that Beyonce is instead saying that there are many kings, but Black kings are among them. Don't you forget it. I think that it addresses, there's some very powerful spoken word parts of the piece. I really do feel it's like an art piece. I wouldn't call it a film. I'd call it like an installation at a museum. But that addressed, you know, being, you know, the Black community being told they don't have the worth that they do. And being robbed of their history. I particularly liked one piece where a gentleman is saying, I can't speak in my native tongue. I'm paraphrasing. I can't speak in my native tongue, so how do I truly know who I am? And if I don't know who I am, how do you know who I am? And I thought that was like, I don't think you can argue with that. I thought that was excellent. So I thought that was great. The importance of self-worth, as I just said, is a big part of Beyonce's Black is King, and it's incredibly effective. I think really only women so far have gotten the same treatment in entertainment, in stories that have been told on a broad scale. And watching this, it made me really hope to see other cultures and ethnicities get the same treatment of Black Panther and Black is King. We've had Coco, Crazy Rich Asians, and the upcoming Shang-Chi. Those are certainly all steps in the right direction. We'll see about Shang-Chi. I think Coco and Crazy, I did not care for Crazy Rich Asians because, well, as you know in my review, but I do respect what it accomplished as a film and representation. But and I loved Coco, but I think that those things are not at the level of Black Panther and Black is King just yet, but they're getting there. And I have to say, two of those are also from Disney, and they have all been very successful. Clearly, the mouse sees that there's green in cultural representation and pride in blockbuster projects. And I'm surprised that it's taking other studios so long to jump on this bandwagon. It's not only the right thing to do, but it's incredibly lucrative. Come on, Hollywood. All right, so Black is King is incredibly ambitious, and Beyonce took a big leap tackling such a huge project and taking almost exclusive ownership for it. There are a couple sub-directors in it, but you know, her name's right on the front of it. If this didn't work out, it would be attributed to her. But it did work out. She delivers, from the settings to the costumes to the ideas. I really do feel she's operating on the level of Michael Jackson here as a music performer, and she looks just as cool doing it. Wow, her wardrobe here. I just loved it. Every costume, I was like, that's amazing. And it was beautiful and powerful. I think that's a consistent theme throughout. I do feel that Black is King is too long. I would have capped it at 45 minutes because I don't think there's enough variation in many ways to sustain the 85-minute running time. Most of the songs are very similar stylistically. And I have to say, they're personally... You know, I like more upbeat things, so I liked those songs better. But I can see that some people, you know, maybe that wouldn't be a problem for others. But I do think that if you're going to have 85 minutes, you want there to be clear distinction between the songs, and I don't think that's always the case. And the visual themes are also very similar most of the time. The urban streets, the new money house, and the debutante ball, I think, are all welcome breaks. The swimming pool, by the way, so Busby Berkeley, I love that. And I think there should have been more visual variation throughout. Also, I don't think there's enough story. An abstract telling of The Lion King is a very clever idea, because we all know the story so well at this point, we can still follow along when Beyonce decides to tell it in broader strokes and to interpret it, which itself is very meaningful and sheds like a new perspective on The Lion King and also, you know, the larger picture. I thought one of the most successful things in the piece was the scar, the hyenas, you know, at the elephant graveyard, and the buffalo stampede. Now, of course, they don't actually have any of those things, but what Beyonce substitutes, and I don't think substitute is a fair word, because I think they were really, really good. But the way she adapted that, let's say, was really clever and compelling. I loved it. I thought that was so strong. But then, as Black is King continues, the Lion King story seems to fade away, and with it, the spine of the piece. And it makes it a little bit harder, I think, to be really drawn into it, because it ceases to have a story, I felt. And also there was a baby in a basket in the beginning, and I'm like, oh, like Moses, but I thought this was a retelling of The Lion King. What are we doing here? So I think, you know, if you're gonna be so abstract in some areas, it benefits you to be more strict in others to allow that abstractness to be successful, just in my opinion. But still, it's a stunning achievement with many unforgettable visuals. And again, an uplifting piece that tells an entire group of people that they should, I think not only the group of people that they should be proud of who they are, but I hope everyone watches this. And I think it tells everyone else that, you know, this community deserves an equal seat at the table. I think that's really great. I also think the emphasis on family, legacy, and keeping your mind sharp, chess is a constant theme throughout, also make Black is King admirable and important. And again, I think something that not only would appeal to younger viewers, but it would be beneficial for them to see it. After Lemonade and now this, you can see Beyonce's growth as a visual artist, it's exponentially expanding. She's really good, and I can't wait to see what she does next. Lemonade certainly appealed to her fan base, but I think Black is King takes her to the next level and reaches beyond that to become, I think, like Hamilton and Fantasia and Michael Jackson music videos, to be like a cultural moment, which is really cool. I didn't, you know, it's funny, Donald Glover, you know, you hear his voice here once because they use some of the sound bites from The Lion King recent CGI version. And I love Donald Glover, but I think we all agreed that unfortunately he wasn't his usual self in the line, you know, voicing the adult Simba. It just didn't quite work out. But I do feel that his This Is America, while obviously much shorter, is also on par with, well, Black is King is uplifting, whereas I think This Is America is, you know, obviously not uplifting, but, you know, it calls attention to you know, stuff that's going on right now. But I, in terms of powerfulness, I think they're on par. So I would hope that Beyonce, who collaborates with lots of other artists in both Lemonade and Black is King, I would hope that, you know, where's Donald Glover? I can't believe he isn't in either one of these. I would hope that he would participate in her next visual album. I'd be very interested to see that. He should make a visual album. I like this idea of visual albums. I wish more artists would consider doing it. I think the death of the music video, because MTV kind of went away, has been very sad, and I would like to see more of that. I think music videos put a lot of great imagery and also ideas into the world, sometimes even more so than movies, because they're shorter and they are more pieces of art. And I think it's been a loss to society to not have that anymore. So I like working to bring it back. So what did you think of Black is King? Share your thoughts down below, subscribe today, and of course, as always, you can check out some more videos right now.